My name is Lily Bloom, and this is my YouTube channel. So, I thought about doing this because I've been writing for a while, and I'm in the process of publishing my first novel. Yes, exciting stuff. So, I started in April 2016. I had an idea for a short, silly story. So I started writing it, and I was like, oh yeah, I'll publish it by July, it'll be done, up to 10,000 words, should be done. So in end of April, I was writing, May, then I started sharing with a few friends, close friends. I started sharing my writing, which was crazy, because I'm like shy. So I sent it to a few friends, and then I was in a group for writers. So I asked a few people if they would like to beta read it, and I think five people accepted to read my stuff. And I think by June I got enough feedback. I got enough feedback that made me write more. So unfortunately didn't make my July deadline because it was meant to be a short story. So I decided to write something more and see where the story takes me. And now it's October, the end of October, we're almost in November. So lots of people are getting ready for November, which is National Novel Writing Month. And the point of National Novel Writing Month is to write 50,000 words in a month. Well, I won't be doing that, but I will be using this month to try and finish the draft of my novella, which is kind of becoming a novel, really. At this point, I will be attempting to finish my draft before the end of November, so I can share it with my beta readers. And after I get feedback from them, I'll make other changes, obviously, accordingly. And then, if I'm satisfied with it, I'll just pay an editor, because don't forget, you need an editor, no matter how good you are at writing. You need someone else's opinion. Beta readers are good, but you still need someone who's good at grammar, and not just grammar, someone who's good at storytelling in general. It's just good to have an opinion. If you can't afford paying one, just use beta readers. But yeah, I would recommend an editor. Obviously, everyone's budgets vary, so you can read lots of books on writing, editing yourself. So yeah, I have set a new deadline for myself, which is 21st of December. But I hope it will be done by then. But I think the proper, like the actual print book and even the ebook will be done like probably in March, to be honest. Like, I really want to get the book out there by December, because really this started, as I was saying, as a short story, and it's just getting longer and longer, and it's just like taking over. But yeah, I mean, I don't think I'll have time to I'll probably have time to finish the draft by the end of November, but I'm not sure how long it will take my beta readers to read it and then send feedback to me, and then I'll have to check it and then make new changes, maybe send it again to beta readers, and then send it to an editor, which will take a while to do the editing as well and send it back to me, and that editing might take even longer after he'll give me feedback and make probably changes. So yeah, I'm just being honest, I don't think I'll finish by December, but March is the latest deadline because it's my birthday, so I just want to have a book by then out. I just want to get it out there. So yeah, and since it's just because it was meant to be a short story, that's just like I was not prepared for it to become a longer, like a novel. So we'll see how that goes. We'll see what feedback I get. Obviously, if I'm not satisfied with it, I will not publish it. But at the moment, getting in shape, and I quite like it. It's exciting what I find out about characters, and yeah, crazy stuff happening. Lots of people, well, not lots of people dying, but quite a few deaths. And heartbreaking stuff happening, although it was meant to be an erotic romance, but now it's getting a little bit darker, so we'll see. I don't even know what genre is gonna fit by the end. Like, I'm aiming to be something like an erotic mystery, but yeah, I will see what my beta readers say as well. Like, so yeah, I didn't tell you what the story is about. Basically, it's about writer, journalist Luke Evans, who has the world at his feet. He's a happy man, and then one day he loses his wife in a car crash and their unborn baby, so pretty sad. And that was the scene which made me want to write more, because I was like, well, if I'm gonna put the character through such a heartbreaking event, I might as well give it more than just a 10,000 words or 5,000 words, which was the initial goal, and then became 10,000. So yeah, and it's about this man who's going through this tragic event in his life, and yes, the way he's coping with it or not, and the characters who come into his life afterwards, basically. So yeah, I'll keep you updated. Yeah, it was meant to be a test video. It's kind of long now, 8 minutes. Oh god. So I'll be posting on this channel, I'll be posting stuff in general about storytelling, and I'll try to read, well, not try, but like I'll give my feedback on certain books that I liked, because, well, reading is subjective, so people like different things. But I will try to give you reviews of my books, of books that I really like, so you have an idea of what kind of stories I like, because those will be the kind of stories that I will try to write in my life. But that doesn't mean I will only talk about books. I will also talk probably about movies and anything to do with storytelling, really. Like, if I have a really good film recommendation, I will just say it. Yeah, so that was it. It's kind of long, but this is what I want to say. Oh yeah, I'll probably do some unboxing videos with books and tell you why I chose the books, because nowadays I read mostly in digital, on Kindle app or Kobo app or whatever. So yeah, but recently I bought 2 books. So I'll be telling you why I chose those books. So yeah, exciting stuff. Thanks for watching, and yeah, hope to see you soon, or you'll be seeing me. have a lovely day.